everyone. This is part two to the fiber paste technique. I'm finishing up the canvas and I'll be narrating through this video, telling you what steps I took and products that I used. So I began with gathering up some embellishments and various items that I have in my own stash, broken pieces and everything. So that's how you start when you work with a mixed media canvas. Now this is the piece that I showed you how I created in part one of this series. And now I'm just using some glossy accents glue to glue it onto the canvas. This frame is from Prima Marketing. It is a resin frame. And all of the products that I'll be using in this canvas will be listed on my blog post, and the link will be in the description box down below. Throughout this project to glue all embellishments. Placement. You move things around and you play around till you get a pleasing look that you enjoy. Stencil, and I use DecoArt's molding paste to put down the Harlequin effect onto the canvas. I wanted to give it a little more texture in a different pattern. Thank you. I'm taking some of the same molded paste, and I'm going to be using the Finnabar Mini Art Stones to create a textured molding paste. Gives it a bite, like sand would, like a gritty bite, because I want to create effects of erosion and on certain areas of this canvas. And you can accomplish this by making it look like it's rusty and crusty by creating that effect using a technique such as this. You can add sand, you can add micro beads to do the same effect. You don't have to have the mini art stones. That's just what happened to be sitting on my table, and that's what I mixed it with. Take some black acrylic paint and go over all of those areas that I've allowed to dry, the erosion created areas, all of the embellishments that I placed on there. Don't be afraid to use black. Black is a beautiful color, and it lends great possibilities to bring out aged looks. Many people are going to ask me, Angela, why did you cover that beautiful piece that you created? Well, that's part of the process. I created that mainly for texture and to make it look like it was a piece of rusted metal in the background, and it done its job, as you will see as this project progresses. But it's really fun to create different things, and there are no rules in crafting. You don't have to show every single piece you've created. Use it. Use it as a foundation. Just have fun with it. I use in this project will be listed in the blog post, and the link will be below in the description box. Taking some blue acrylic paint, and I'm going over areas that I want to enhance. Also, this helps blend in those Lindy's colors to blend into the background and also bring forward. Again, mixed media is all about layers. One of the three-part steps that is in the Finibar patina effects kit, and I'm using the mint green one in that kit, and I'm putting this atop the eroded areas that I created to give it even more of a bite or 3D effect, because this particular product has grit in it as well. Taking a brush and I'm blending out the edges and blending this product out and into the canvas. Some of the areas. Like I said, it's all about layers. In the same Finibar patina effects kit, and now I'm going over all of the raised areas. Just watch it just come alive when you use this particular color. Dry brushing technique. I don't have a lot of paint loaded onto my paintbrush because I don't want to be heavy-handed. I want it to look aged and you know, rustic and eroded. Thank you. here I'm about to assemble using the Tim Holtz paper dolls. I have to say this is one of my favorite products he's come out with. It's like you get hundreds of different paper vintage looking paper dolls in various sizes, and it's perfect for projects like this. Acrylic paints and the brass paint to just go over the edges of the typed out words that I printed out on my computer. One says spread your wings and unlock, and the other one says unlock the possibilities. And again, here I'm just adding detail to the paper doll, and you'll learn to do that when you start working with mixed media a lot. You'll be like, you gotta pay attention to all the edges and details. Centers to the flowers. They're just basic beads that I had. And then I'm going to use some white acrylic paint, water it down really well, and then start doing paint drops. Be sure to cover the faces of your paper dolls, because you don't want paint drops like splattered in their face or anything. So just take mindful of that. But this is about it. This is the end of the project. I take black acrylic paint and go around the edges. Be sure to stay for photos at the end of the video. Also, check out the blog post for all the links and details of the products that I used. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And if you like the recorded version better than the live version, let me know in the comments below as well. Give me a thumbs up. So until next crafty project, I will see you then. Bye-bye.